really pop in that red. I show them what it's going to look like. So yellows, ugh, you've seen some yellows that look like they are just glowing.
And it's not unusual to see tweaked RGBs. A lot of times in the corporate guides or in the templates that go out, it will say, this is based on your corporate blue. But when it's projected on white, it's not strong enough.
So we really need to tell them that this is not print. Inks react differently to those color values than light coming through.
I would want to do all the formatting before I ungrouped. Get it as perfect as I know how to get it. Then ungroup it, perhaps regroup it. Then the animation is easy. And I decide. I decide whether I want to go column by column or whether I want to go row by row. I decide that. I'm the editor of this data, and animation gives me that opportunity to decide what's the best way to tell this story.
And so we have hyperlinks down at the bottom that would skip to the slide that depicts the answer that someone sent. So
some of that audience said taller.
Taller people. You know, and then the next part was, this is in order, but it doesn't have to be in this order. Somebody can jump by. Somebody with a ladder.
And the audience was saying this, and he's clicking on the hyperlink to pull that out, whatever they say.
Somebody says, well, if I hide them, then nobody's ever going to see them. You can't use them. Well, actually, you know what? Even during the presentation, you can go and access a hidden slide.
I think the type is too big. The type competes with it too much. Like, if we eliminate the type, that's just such a great image. And now, I can easily see the white space, if you will, the blue space, the open space, where I think that we can create prominence to the text message without it being that big. We can put the branding in the lower right corner. We still have plenty of space here for some properly sized text. And I think now we've blended those elements a little bit better. Right? So it's not competing with each other. Frankly, I think that this becomes more prominent because of its space. Space around an element is every bit as important as the element itself.
What I do know is the difference between our help center and the help center people are used as by phoning up help centers. And basically what they get is somebody with a book who's reading a list of answers. What we get here is people that use PowerPoint every day of their lives who are passionate about it and never use anything else quite often and often know the answers. And if they don't, they're not going to sleep until they find them.